Hi students, hope everyone is fine and safe. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to my new video. And today's video is about TCS VO internship. In this video, I'm going to explain you how to complete TCS VO internship in 10 days in a successful manner. So come, let's watch the video. So the first step, what you have to do in TCS VO internship is to activate the code which you received from your professors. So you would have received an activation code, or else you can also purchase any one of the internship product by yourself. So if you have the activation code, what you have to do is you have to go to this particular website, TCS ION Digital Learning Hub website, where you can click on activate now. And as soon as you click on the activate now, it will ask you to create a new account. You can see the button, you can see create account. If you click that, it will ask you to type all your information like name, password, username, everything. So you can just type the name, username, and all those things. And if you click create account, it will automatically create an account. And as soon as you create that particular account, you can go ahead and activate your product. That is, whenever you create an account, you will get a pop-up screen to activate your account like this. And you have to enter the activation code, and if you hit enter, that particular product will be added or activated in your account. The account will be created and you can see which internship product you have selected. But to start the internship process, what you have to do is you have to complete the another registration process where you have all the details about internship details. As soon as you click that, as soon as you created the account, you will be having the TCS ION registration screen where you have to type personal details, academic details, and then internship details. This is very, very important. If you click on internship details, you will have all the list of products which is available in this internship. That is, you're going to do any particular project, it will be listed in this particular drop down menu where you can able to see a lot of projects like digitization of attendance management or something like that. Whatever projects we are willing to do, you can select that particular project, and then at the last you will be having academic mentor details. You can type the academic mentor details, and so this project will be reflecting on your account, and if you click on launch, it will launch that particular screen. So this is very, very important screen which tells you how to process the TCS internship process. Okay, so you can see here the left hand side, you will have three PDFs, which is very, very important. First one is day wise plan, and the second one is project reference material, and the third one is industry project. And apart from it, you have another important thing which is called as a digital discussion room, where you can able to go ahead and discuss all the doubts which you have, and you can submit all the reports which you create during the internship process. So everything will be discussed in that digital discussion room. And apart from it, you can also have activity report and project report. So have one main thing in your mind, like to complete this particular internship process, it is an online internship process where you have to submit day-wise report, and that report will be evaluated. And after completing 10 days of activity report, you have to submit the project report. And once you submit report, you'll be having a waiver report which has to be submitted by you after discussing with your academic mentor, and then after that you'll be having a small test, and after completing the test your internship will be over. Okay, so now I'll tell you the internship. So first thing is this three PDF is very important, that is day wise plan, project reference material, and industry project. Only with this three PDFs you're going to do the internship. Day wise plan will tell you what you have to do each and every day, how many hours you have to spend, and what is that you have to do on a daily manner. And project reference material is a material which will have all the information, all the study material which is needed for this particular project. And then the last one is industry project, which will tell you how you have to proceed with this particular project. What is the objective and what is the working which has been expected for this particular project? Everything will be explained in this particular industry project. So now I'll explain day wise plan. Right, before that I'll tell you I have already said what is digital discussion room, where you have to discuss about your doubts, and also any activity report which you submitted It will be uploaded in this particular discussion room where you can able to interact with your industry mentor. So this is the screen where you can able to discuss with your industry mentor. As soon as you launch the digital discussion room, you can go ahead and ask a lot of questions, or else you can also submit the report and you can inform here that you have completed that particular activity report, and you can ask the industry mentor to evaluate that particular thing, right? So this is the digital discussion room. And now I'll tell you the daily activity. How is that to do it, right? The first thing, as I said, the first PDF which I said is day-wise plan. So day-wise plan will be having the complete overview of how to proceed with your internship process. Like as soon as you log in, as soon as you launch, you'll be having a small pre-project test which will test your aptitude and as well as your logical thinking ability. It's a very basic test. And after that, you will be having project references which combines of all the materials which is needed to complete this. Knowledge sharing is a place, is the digital discussion room where you can able to ask a lot of questions and also discuss with your industry mentor, right? So this is the reports which you have to submit during this internship process. The first thing is activity report, which you have to submit on a daily basis. Daily, from day 1 to day 10, you have to submit this activity report, and that will be evaluated by your industry mentor. And after completing that activity report, you have to submit the project report. Project report is what you have done all these 10 days. You got to summarize that and you have to submit it in a report form, and even that will be evaluated by the industry mentor. And then you'll be having a project test which will be for 10 marks, and you have to secure at least 5 marks in that. So that will be reflecting in your dashboard as well. The marks, the performance, everything will be reflecting in your performance, right? Then the Viva. After completing all these activities, you have to submit the Viva report, which will be like a feedback form, like a feedback which you get from your academic mentor, and you have to submit that as a report. That is a Viva report. And after completing all this process, you have to submit a feedback to get the certificate. Okay. So now this is the day-wise plan. Like in this day-wise plan, you can see each and every day what you have to do. Like the day 1, you have to complete at least 2 references in project reference, and then day 2, another 2 references, day 3, another 2 references. This will tell you how you have to proceed with your daily activities, like how many hours you have to spend, and what is the report you have to submit. Everything will be given in this particular schedule. So if you follow this particular schedule, you can easily complete this particular internship process, right? And the next one is, this is the just a screenshot of your project reference material, where you will be having the links for various study materials. Like in order to complete this particular project, you will have to go through a lot of materials, and everything will be given in this particular project reference material. And then you'll be having another PDF, which I said, which is industry project, which will tell you what is that particular project and how is that you have to proceed with it. Like you can see here, the project objective and brief project guidelines has been summarized here. They tell you why is that you have to doing that particular project and how is that you have to proceed that particular project. That will be cleanly explained in this particular industry project. And then how your project has been evaluated, like what is the exact project outcome, what is that you have to achieve, even that will be completely explained in industry project, right? So now this is the internship process screen, where, you know, once after completing all the things, like you will get a tick marks, you can see a tick marks over here, like after completing all the day-wise plan, project reports and activity report, everything, you'll get a tick mark, and then you have to submit the feedback to get your certificate. Okay, so now I'll tell you the activity report, how the activity report will be. Like you can see the screen where you have to fill all these details, name of the student, an internship project, name of the organization, everything, and the date, and the day 1 or day 2, something like that, and hours you have spent, and what are the activities you have done for that particular day. Like each and every day you have to submit this particular report, and you have to mention in the discussion room that you have completed this activity, and you'll ask the industry mentor, you can request the industry mentor to evaluate that particular report. So after evaluating, you can go to the next report. class, you got to submit the project report. This is how you have to proceed with this internship. And then I have said something about Viva report, which has been given by your, it is like a feedback which you get from your academic mentor. Okay, so this is the mentor screen where the mentor can able to see all the screens, like all the reports and all the performances which regarding your internships. Like you can see all the students' name will be reflecting in your mentor screen. This you cannot able to see all these things. This is a mentor login where mentor can able to see the complete list of students, their performance, and what is the project they are doing, everything. Okay, and then they can also see your performances. Like you can see here the project report which is you have submitted, they can able to download it, and you can see the performance ratings which is done by the industry mentor. Everything can be done, everything can be seen by your mentor. Like after seeing all these reports, they will give you a suggestion or a feedback. Like the project is done, you can able to proceed, you can submit, your performance is satisfactory, or you have to rework all those things like that. They will give a feedback, and you have to enter that particular feedback. And after entering that particular feedback, you can submit it as a Viva report so that you can obtain the certificate. This is the overall process of your TCS Rio internship. I believe you can able to understand what is that you're going to do. I believe second years and third years have a lot of difficulty in completing this particular TCS Rio internship. All you have to do is log in, use those three PDFs in a very beautiful manner, and then complete each and every day activity report on a daily basis. After completing all these reports, submit your project report and then submit your Viva report so that you can complete the project very easily, the internship very easily. Okay. So if you have any doubts, you can always ask in the comment section. I'll be very happy to do that. Okay. Then thank you very much for watching this particular video. I believe this video will be very useful for you for completing your TCS Rio internship. Thank you, students. Subscribe, Passionate Professor, and keep learning. Thank you very much.